In the past few decades, humans have developed a variety of deep-sea exploration technologies to explore the depths of the ocean. From the original submarines to today's modern unmanned remote-controlled submersibles, scientists have revealed many previously unknown deep-sea creatures and terrains. However, how to efficiently develop seabed mineral resources remains a big challenge we need to face in the future. Recently, Chinese scientists have made a breakthrough in this regard. They have developed the world's first intelligent electric-driven deep-sea mining vehicle. After 5 sea trial dives, this mining vehicle has proven to be able to perform key operations such as exploration, collection, and transportation in the ocean at a depth of 6,000 meters. This achievement shocked Japanese engineers because China's technology is ahead of them. So, in today's video, we will introduce the powerful functions of this Chinese deep-sea mining vehicle in detail and explore how many untapped mineral resources are hidden on the seabed. If you like our video content, please click to subscribe to my YouTube channel so that you can receive all our latest video content. Now, let's get into today's topic. Did you know? Mineral resources have many important uses in human life. From smelting metals and building materials to making daily necessities, pharmaceutical chemical raw materials, and carving crafts, mineral resources are the basis for us to enjoy modern life. According to statistics, the world's proven iron ore reserves are about 170 billion tons, bauxite reserves are about 55 billion tons, copper reserves are about 800 million tons, lead ore reserves are about 89 million tons, zinc ore reserves are about 230 million tons, and phosphate reserves are about 71 billion tons. The world's proven oil reserves are as high as 1.73 trillion barrels, and natural gas reserves are about 196.9 trillion cubic meters. However, since the early 19th century, people have been exploiting oil in large quantities. As time goes by, the mineral resources on land will eventually run out. Therefore, scientists and engineers now turn their attention to the vast deep sea, hoping to find new resources there to meet human development. As we all know, the ocean covers 71% of the Earth's surface, so the mineral resources in the ocean are much richer than those on land. Moreover, under the special environmental conditions of the ocean, some unique minerals that are not available on land can be generated. According to official data, the total reserves of seabed manganese nodules worldwide have exceeded 3 trillion tons. Among them, Asia has the largest reserves, reaching 1.5 trillion tons. These manganese nodules not only contain manganese, but also rich in nickel, copper, cobalt, and other valuable metals. In addition to manganese nodules, the ocean also contains other rich mineral resources, with an estimated total of more than 1.6 trillion tons. This includes an estimate of the global amount of methane hydrate resources, which exceeds trillions of cubic meters. These methane hydrates are a potential source of clean energy in the future. In addition, the ocean contains more than 5 billion tons of copper ore, more than 9 billion tons of nickel ore, and 3 billion tons of cobalt ore. The reserves of these resources are equivalent to more than 50 times that of landmines. So for decades, countries have invested in research and development of seabed mineral resources. As far as I know, countries such as Belgium, India, and Canada have been actively researching and experimenting with offshore mining technology. As early as 2018, Belgium and India tested mining vehicles at 4,500 meters and 5,270 meters deep in the sea, respectively. In the same year, Canada also conducted mineral collection and transportation tests at a depth of 4,400 meters. These actions have further promoted the development of deep-sea mining technology. As an island country, Japan has also made significant progress in the field of deep-sea mining. In 2017, a Japanese scientific team developed a deep-sea mining vessel specifically designed to support seabed mining robots. The ship is equipped with advanced seabed navigation and communication systems that can monitor and control seabed mining activities in real time to ensure the safety and efficiency of the mining process. According to statistics, in 2020, Japan has successfully collected 649 kilograms of cobalt and nickel-rich minerals from the seabed at a depth of 1,600 meters. Although Japan has made progress in seabed mineral mining, China recently announced the development of the world's first intelligent electric-driven deep-sea mining vehicle and successfully started mining on the seabed. So, what exactly is this intelligent mining vehicle? In June this year, China's technical team announced the successful development of a deep-sea mining vehicle called Kaichuo No. 2. This equipment is specially designed for mining seabed resources up to 6,000 meters deep. It is reported that this is the world's first intelligent electric-driven deep-sea heavy-duty mining vehicle platform, which means that China has made a greater breakthrough in the field of deep-sea mining technology. By July, Kaichuo No. 2 conducted 5 test dives in the Western Pacific, 4 of which reached a depth of 2,000 meters, and one reached 4,102.8 meters, setting a new national diving depth record. During these experiments, Kaichuo No. 2 showed extremely excellent performance and reliability. It successfully crossed steep seabed mountains with a slope of more than 30 degrees and overcame complex and rugged terrain, and finally successfully collected more than 200 kilograms of mineral resources. It is worth mentioning that the size of Kaichuo No. 2 is quite large, with a length of 6 meters, a width of 3 meters, a height of 2.5 meters, and a weight of about 14 tons. This device has a tough appearance and is fully functional. It is equipped with up to 8 mechanical arms and can perform a variety of operations. In addition, the Kaichuo 2 also integrates advanced technologies such as intelligent path planning, tracking, and obstacle avoidance, as well as an environmental monitoring system. These technologies ensure the safety and efficiency of operations, enabling it to successfully perform tasks in complex seabed environments. But the Kaichuo 2 is not just a deep-sea mining tool. It also includes 5 sets of important equipment such as deep-sea exploration equipment, collection devices, and conveying systems. These equipment combine the latest technologies of digitalization, electrification, and intelligence, and represent the future development direction of deep-sea mining technology. China's advanced technology in this deep-sea mining equipment also completely shocked Japanese engineers. They could not believe that China's progress in this field was so rapid that it had even surpassed Japan. But what is even more shocking is that in actual operation, the Kaichuo 2 determined the distribution and reserves of mineral resources through high-precision exploration technology. These technologies include sonar, seismic exploration, and magnetic surveying, which can map the seabed topography in detail and identify the location and scale of mineral deposits. Subsequently, it uses advanced robotic arms and mining tools to mine minerals. Unlike traditional mining vehicles, the Kaichuo 2 cancels the traditional power unit and relies entirely on electric drive when operating on the seabed. The energy storage battery on the vehicle can ensure that it can work for several hours on the seabed, and it also has the function of charging in the sea. This means that there is a special charging device above the worksite, and the power generated by the ship is transmitted to the seabed mining vehicle through the connecting line to ensure sufficient power supply so that it can continue to work efficiently. So, has the deep-sea mining vehicle developed by China already led the world? Of course, China has the deep-sea mining vehicle Kaichuo No. 2, which means that China has taken the initiative in deep-sea resource exploitation and will actively promote deep-sea mining in the future. You should know that the average depth of the world's oceans is about 3,688 meters, and 80% of the oceans are less than 6,000 meters deep. The Kaichuo No. 2, developed by China, can work at a depth of 6,000 meters on the seabed, which also means that mining in most seabed areas around the world will become possible. With this advanced deep-sea mining equipment, China can carry out deep-sea mining operations worldwide and further enhance its influence in the international resource market. But according to my speculation, China is likely to first mine seabed minerals in the South China Sea in the future. Do you know why? According to preliminary data, the average depth of the South China Sea is 1,212 meters, and the deepest is only 5,559 meters. The known metal or reserves in the South China Sea are as high as 55 billion tons, making it one of the world's major sedimentary basins. This huge reserve provides broad prospects for the development of China's mineral resources. In addition, China discovered in 2022 that there are 37 sedimentary basins in the South China Sea with geological conditions for oil and gas accumulation, with a total area of about 50 million hectares, equivalent to 6 times the area of the North Sea oil-producing area in Western Europe, and it is China's largest marine oil and gas storage area. The oil reserves in the South China Sea may be between 23 billion and 30 billion barrels, and the natural gas reserves are between 7.5 trillion and 9 trillion cubic meters. Once China starts mining in the South China Sea, it can not only solve the energy resource problem, but also grow the economy through exports. However, deep-sea mining is not completely uncontroversial. A report by Greenpeace pointed out that deep-sea mining may cause chemical pollution, noise, vibration, and light interference, posing a threat to the seabed ecosystem. Indeed, deep-sea mining activities will produce a large amount of floating objects, which may cover the water for a long time and suffocate marine life. In addition, noise, vibration, and light interference may also affect the behavior and communication of marine mammals and destroy the balance of marine ecology. Moreover, for nearly 20 years, the United Nations has been trying to formulate the seabed mining regulations specifically for the mining and management of mineral resources in the high seas. Before this regulation was passed, large-scale, industrialized mining of mineral resources was not allowed in the high seas. Faced with these challenges, the Chinese scientific research team did not give up. They are actively studying how to protect the marine environment while developing seabed resources, seeking a win-win situation for economic development and ecological protection. So, do you think humans should start seabed mining? To not miss out on our future projects and news updates, please make sure you subscribe to our channel and turn on notifications. We will continue to provide you with more exciting and interesting content.